Hi, I'm Di Huizer from PLR Planners, and I've just made an update to my Photoshop sticker maker. I've added a brand new template and I just wanted to show you how to use it. So I've created a set of gradient stickers that are very easy for you to manage and update. And when you open the file, you'll see it's called gradient stickers. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in a piece of paper, let's say that I'm using on a particular planner. And let's bring in that one just to pick up the color codes. So I'll just pick that one up there, and I'm going to use my color picker over here to pick up, let's say, that blue. So now I've got the blue, and I'm going to go in and I'm going to copy that code over here. So now what I'm going to do is, now that I've picked up my color, I'm now going to go to a site that Sean Hansen referred me to. And it's an HTML color picker site which gives you gradients, and I'm very grateful for this because this is a very handy tool. So once you've opened it up, and I'll put the link in the description below, you'd copy and you'd paste that code that you've just picked up from Photoshop and put it in there, and then click on the update button. And now what it's going to do is it's going to give you a whole series of gradients over here. Now my suggestion is that you don't try and jump layers because it doesn't look very effective. So let's say we start off with that. I'm going to copy and paste that code over there by going Control C, and then I'm going to go back into Photoshop, and I'm going to go to my gradient stickers over here, and you'll see over here I've got a colorful mask. So I'm going to double click that one. And I'm going to paste the code over there, and then I'm going to say okay, and then I'm going to go back to the color gradient, and I'm going to pick up the next one. Okay, so now my gradient stickers are ready, and then what I'm going to do is I've also got added some vellum cards, which you can do the same thing, where you can either bring in a background image by selecting the smart object and then bringing in a piece of paper, let's say something like that. So accepting it and then saving it, and now you'll see that it's got a border around on the outside. Now, if you don't want to use a piece of paper as a background image on these vellum cards, you can just simply select the same colors over here as you've got in the gradient. So I'm going to go to my color picker. I'm going to pick up that color over there, and then I'm going to go to this field over here, select the color over there, and say okay, and then do the same with the next ones. So we'll select the next color, and we'll do that. And then we'll move down to the next level and pick up the next one. Pick it up there. Pick up the next color. Pick it up there. And then do the last one. Okay, so now you've got gradient vellum cards that have got the similar color as the gradients that you've got above. Now, once you're done with all of that, you would save the document. Now, if I want to split them into individual PNG files, I'm going to go up to my crop tool over here, and I'm going to go to slice select tool, make sure that that's activated, and then I'm going to go to file, save for web, and you can see the guidelines over here, and click on save. And we're going to have a subdirectory called gradient stickers PNG, so let's just move it to the right subdirectory. And inside my subdirectory, you'll see that now each of those files have been created individually. Okay, and once you've finished with that, then what you can do is you can run the action to crop the PNG files so that they look a little bit smaller. Okay, I hope that's helped. Anybody who's actually bought the sticker maker already, you will find the updated files in your dashboard. Have fun!